So dear students, I am today here with thermodynamics lecture 2, that's thermodynamic properties of a system. In this lecture, we are going to study extensive and intensive properties. Now this lecture is very important for board exam as well as for competitive exam, because questions have been asked from this concept. Questions are asked like this. He gives certain properties and you have to tell which one is extensive or intensive property. Let's understand the concept. Now, extensive properties are those properties of the system, whose magnitude depend upon the amount of substance present in the system. Those properties whose magnitude depend upon the amount of substance present in the system, they are called extensive properties. Examples we have mass, volume, internal energy, entropy, this is internal energy, this is entropy, enthalpy, Gibbs free energy, del G, Gibbs free energy. Change in free energy, change in internal energy, change in entropy, change in enthalpy. They are all extensive properties. And intensive properties are those properties of thermodynamic system which does not depend upon, they are independent upon amount of substance present in the system. They do not depend upon amount of substance present in the system. For example, very important, we have density. We have temperature, pressure, etc. We will see other examples as well. Now, but how can you tell that? How can you convince yourself that mass is an extensive property? Volume is an extensive property. Temperature is not an extensive property. Now, here is a catch. What we are going to do, right, along with me, if on dividing the system into two or more parts, the property gets divided, means the magnitude of property gets divided, then it is extensive property. Otherwise, it is not. Otherwise, it's intensive property. What I mean by this, if I take, for example, a beaker of water, this is 100 ml beaker of water, it contains 100 ml of water. If I divide this beaker into two small halves, this water into two small beakers, if I made these halves equal, then tell me, will this beaker contain 100 ml of water? No. It will have 50 ml of water. What's 100 ml of water? It's volume of water. Now, I have divided the thermodynamic system into two parts. The property that's volume also gets divided. Hence, volume is an extensive property. That's why volume is extensive property. Similarly, we can explain mass as an extensive property. Let us take a container. Suppose this container contains 80 grams of substance. If you divide this container into two parts, tell me how much amount, two equal parts, how much amount will be present in this container, this part, and how much in this part. If the parts are equal, here we will have 40 grams, and where here we will have 40 grams. Therefore, mass of a substance is a property, but this property gets divided on dividing the system. Therefore, mass is an extensive property. Now, very important among these examples is concentration. Now, tell me, what's concentration? Concentration, is it intensive property or extensive property? Now, to explain it, let us take a juice bottle. Let this juice bottle contain 100 ml of juice. Now, if I divide it into two or three parts, or more than three parts, four parts of equal volume, or it may not be equal volume as well. This is part A, part B, part C, part D. Tell me the concentration of the juice, the concentration in this bottle of juice, is it same as in this case? Same as in this case, same as in this case, same as in this case, or different? For me, it is same. The concentration is same in all the cases. Therefore, concentration, which was the property, concentration, property, concentration, property does not get divided. Concentration remains same. Therefore, concentration is an intensive property. Intensive property. Now, क्या करोगे आप? घर में एक water का glass लोगे. Take a glass of water. This is a glass of water. Add sugar to it. This is sugar. Let the concentration of the sugar in this glass of water is 0.01 molar concentration. Now, divide this big glass of water into small glasses. Tell me, what will be the concentration of sugar in this water, in this water, in this glass of water, in this glass of water? I think it is same, 0.01, means concentration has not changed. Concentration has not got divided. Therefore, concentration is an intensive property. Now, there are certain important points for this topic. Point number one is that ratio of two extensive properties is always intensive property. Ratio of two extensive properties is always intensive. For example, we have seen that mass is extensive, volume is extensive. Now, what about density? Density is mass per unit volume. It is then intensive property. It is per unit volume. It's intensive property. Therefore, we can get a conclusion from here. Extensive by extensive is always equal to intensive. This is conclusion number one. Very important. This question has been asked. Density is number first intensive, number second extensive, number third both, number fourth none of the above. Therefore, it's an intensive property because it is ratio of two extensive properties. Now, density, concentration, they are very important. Point number two, if we divide any extensive property if any extensive property is divided or it is taken as per unit volume or per unit mass. Extensive property per unit volume or per unit mass is always intensive. Very important point. Extensive property per unit volume or per unit mass is always intensive property. For example, molarity is defined number of moles per unit volume. Now see, what's number of moles? Take a container. Let this container contains 50 number of moles. There are 50 number of moles. Divide this container into two equal halves. Tell me, how many moles will be there and how many will be there? I think there will be 25 and 25 here. Therefore, number of moles is a property which gets divided after dividing the system. Therefore, number of moles is extensive property. Extensive per unit volume or per unit mass is always intensive. Now, these are certain important pointers. Now, the most important among these which may be asked in the competitive exams are your density, number second concentration, number third molarity, number fourth molar specific heat. Which among these is intensive property? The question is, which among these is intensive property? Now let us solve this question. Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass is extensive, volume is extensive, therefore density is intensive. This is correct. Concentration I have already explained. Concentration is number of moles per unit volume. It's extensive number of moles, volume is extensive, therefore it is intensive. This is also correct. Now molarity is also concentration. Molarity is equal to number of moles per unit volume, means extensive by extensive, it's also intensive. Molar specific heat means specific heat upon mass of substance in grams or in kgs, in grams. Now specific heat divided by mass of substance, in extensive property per unit mass, it's intensive property. Therefore all of these 1, 2, 3, 4 all are intensive properties. Now there's a homework for you. Categorize the following into intensive and extensive properties. Molarity, concentration, internal energy del U, entropy del S, Gibbs free energy del G. Well, specific heat, molar specific heat, temperature, pressure, volume, number of moles. You have to classify them into intensive and extensive property. Now, one of the example I am going to explain is temperature. You may feel it little bit difficult. Now take a container, take water in the container, heat the water till its boiling point, that's 100 degrees centigrade. Now divide this into two equal parts. Tell me what will be the temperature of this hot water and what will be the temperature of this hot water. Will it be same or different? Same. 100 degree centigrade. 100 degree centigrade. अरे सोचो यार, आप एक पानी का गिलास लेते हो, उसको बॉईल करते हो 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड पे, फिर उसको दो गिलास में बांट रहे हो, क्या आपको एक गिलास सर्द लगता है या दूसरा गर्म लगता है? नो, इट कांट हैपन. टेम्परेचर ऑफ बोथ द गिलासेस विल बी सेम. देयरफॉर दिस टेम्परेचर प्रॉपर्टी, इट डज नॉट गेट डिवाइडेड, नॉट गेट्स डिवाइडेड, देयरफॉर इज एन इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी. Students, do prepare well. These are precious days. Don't waste your time. So, this is our today's topic. It comes to an end. Hope you watch this video till end. Please subscribe and press bell icon so that whenever I will upload a next video, you will get notification of that. Thank you.